Hi everyone, my name is Britt Kondravy and I am the Environmental Education Manager at Wildlands Conservancy. Today I'm here at the beautiful Dorothy Ryder Pool Wildlife Sanctuary in Emmaus, Pennsylvania to talk to you about one of my favorite creatures. Now this creature is known to slither and strike and stare with unblinking eyes. Can you guess what it is? If you're thinking snakes, you'd be correct. Now, Pennsylvania has 21 different species of snakes, but only 3 of them are venomous. Do you recognize any of the snakes in my hands? All of these snakes have a very well-developed skeletal structure. They're vertebrates, like us. This means they have a backbone. This is what the skeleton of a snake looks like. Can you see how long the backbone is and how many ribs it has? Snakes are covered in scales. This makes them reptiles. Can you think of any other reptiles that are covered in scales? If you're thinking turtles and lizards, you'd be correct again. All of these reptiles are what we call poikilothermic. This means that their body temperature is variable. So the temperature of their body is related to the temperature of their surroundings. You may see a snake basking on a rock, basking on the boardwalk here at the sanctuary. Snakes move throughout the day from one temperature zone to another in order to regulate those bodily functions. Now, we have 2 snakes with me here today. They are education snakes. They are not native to Pennsylvania. This means that they are not found naturally living here. It is not legal to sell snakes in a pet store that are native to your state. One of the snakes is from the Southeast United States, and another snake would be native to a whole nother continent. So let's meet my first snake, Carolina. Okay. Carolina might not be native to Pennsylvania, but she sure does have adaptations that are very similar to snakes found here. Can you see her flicking her tongue? Snakes do not have limbs to monitor their environment. So they will stick out that tongue and capture scent molecules. They bring these scent molecules into their mouth where they have something called a Jacobson's organ. That's located on the roof of their mouth, and it's basically 2 holes that allow the prongs of their forked tongue to fit into them perfectly. And those scent chemicals are sent directly to their brain where they can interpret what they're smelling and even from what direction it's coming from. It's similar to the way we use our nose. So we can use our mouth to breathe, but if we want to smell something good or we don't want to smell something bad, we cover our nose because our nose is linked to our brain the way the Jacobson's organ in a snake is linked to their brain. Now, what are they smelling? They can be smelling prey. The species of snake will determine what prey they're hunting for, but it could be anything from insects to worms to amphibians, birds, even small mammals. By smelling the air, the snakes can pick up on scent trails. They can also use this ability to find mates and even find their way back to the area where they spent the winter in. So when Carolina sticks out her tongue, she's not trying to say to me, "You smell delicious." She's simply just trying to smell the air to learn more about the environment around her. She may not have legs or arms, but she has many muscles in her body which allow her to contract the muscles and squeeze onto my arm or a branch for balance. She moves by contracting those muscles and by using the scales on her belly to grip the ground and move forward. Now, as Carolina gets bigger and bigger, she'll need to do something called shedding. She does this about 4 times a year as a young snake, and then it may only happen twice a year as a snake gets older. A snake that's healthy will shed in one long piece. They do this by rubbing their head on something rough like a rock, and then they wiggle out of that shed and they leave it behind. If you've seen something like this in your yard, you may have a snake neighbor. Not to worry though, most snakes that you'll see here in Pennsylvania are not venomous. The 3 venomous snakes we do have are the timber rattlesnake, the copperhead, and the eastern massasauga. So when people see a snake, they often feel afraid because they're afraid that that snake might hurt them. But snakes just want to live and grow and feed and reproduce like every other living creature. And the more we know about them, the more we can respect them and hopefully protect them as well. So if you see a snake in the wild, observe it, notice it, but then back away and go around. If you don't try to handle it, it's not likely to bite or attack you. So I hope this presentation helped you gain a little bit more appreciation for this often misunderstood creature. They participate in great pest control for us. They're a vital part of the ecosystem, and many of them have been injured throughout the years by people who are simply afraid of them and didn't understand their habits or the way they function in the environment. So I hope that you can help me protect them and help protect the beautiful habitat that they need to survive.